The Frank Haith Show, brought to you by Don Thornton Cadillac, Pepsi, River Spirit, TTCU, The Credit Union, Bill Knight Ford, and St. Francis Health System. And now your host, Bruce Howard.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to the Frank Haith Show. I'm Bruce Howard, joined by the basketball coach at the University of Tulsa, Frank Haith. And coach, boy, what a difference a week makes. A couple of wins, obviously, makes the coach happy, makes everybody happy, and obviously your team played better, didn't they?
We did, and you know, getting back home, because we had two games on the road the week before, and it was good to see our guys come back home and play with great focus, and we got better this week, Bruce. I thought we played really well both games. I thought our offense was particularly both games were good, but the second half of the East Carolina game, we played as well as we played all year in terms of just confidence, the way the ball moved. We didn't turn the ball over. And then I thought our defense, in terms of blocking out, rebounding the ball, we did a lot of good things this week.
So Tulsa goes 2-0 in the week and gets to 8-8 in the American Athletic Conference. A little later on, we'll take a look at the jumbled standings and get you ready for the tournament coming up. But before that, of course, two more games for TU on the road to end the regular season. In a moment, we'll be back and we'll talk about University of Tulsa in South Florida here at the Reynolds Center when the Frank Haith Show continues.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for seven straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a seven-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show, and coach, finally back home again at the Reynolds Center taking on South Florida. What were the things you were thinking about coming in? And obviously, just get a win, right?
Right, and the thing that you can't do is look at just their record. They're a good team. They're pretty athletic, and they've been playing a lot better.
Yeah, they come into the game with just one win in the league, and here's what was really good early on. You had intensity, and you played well defensively.
Got some live ball turnovers here and active hands. Obviously that was the end of a clock. Shot clock play there, but good shot by Tapp, and you know, that's being at home.
Gives you a 3-0 lead, and then you're doing some really nice trapping here and force a timeout.
Yeah, and our three-quarter press has been good both games, and it's something I think we can go to here at the end of the year, and it's been good for us. And there you see Junior E2, one of the luxury of having a forward that can bust out, dribble, and find an open Pat Burt in the corner.
So an assist for E2, and good to see Burt get it going as Tulsa has the early 6-0 lead. And you had a great start in this game, didn't you?
Yeah, I think we jumped out 15-1, but it was all about our good ball movement, playing inside out. See that ball goes in the paint area and good reversal to the other side. And Junior E2 is shooting the ball very well.
That made it 9-0. As coach mentioned, the lead would get as large as 15-1. Pat Burt missed on that one, but a nice job by Martins Igbanu.
Good patience by Martins in finishing through defense. And, you know, South Florida's got some long athletic players in the paint. But he's got three big long guys around him. He still gets that ball up on the rim.
And that made it 13-1 on the way to the 15-1 start. But as you can see, USF made a few shots. And there's Pat Bertigan for you.
Nice find by Sterling. And he's the guy that we could talk about too, has done a nice job here this week in getting his game back.
Good to see Jaleel Wheeler knock down a three.
Yeah, and Ja can shoot the ball when he's got his feet underneath him and he's got his, you know, ready hands, ready feet. He's a good shooter.
Nice job by TK Iadoge to be ready for that rebound.
Yeah, and I think TK had a good week too. He really made some nice plays off the bench.
And there's Pat Burt again. And when Pat Burt hits two of those a game, you're very good.
9-3, right?
And yep.
I think good baseline drive, baseline drift by Pat. And we really felt like against their zone, we could attack their corners because their big guys are running out on us.
And so the Hurricane extending their lead up by 8. As Jaleel Wheeler did a nice job there of finding the crease.
Nice drive, good finish by Ja. And this is really good play by Martin, showing his ability in terms of working on his skill set and getting better.
Will Magne with the dunk for Tulsa. And here's another display of good defense, and Pat Burt finishes.
You know, we need more of those live balls where we can, you know, get active with our hands and some easy buckets.
And again, a finish by Jaleel Wheeler, so good at getting it in from the rim.
Nice patience right here by Junior, good find, and a good finish by Martins.
So at halftime, now USF had made their run, Coach, but it's 39-34, not a bad first half for your team.
It isn't. You know, obviously Thorpe had a good run there for them, but I thought our guys, we were in a good place at this point in time.
We go to the second half now, and again, good high-low passing, and again, the good patience here by Martin Zigbanu without traveling.
Yeah, keeping his foot down and good strength there to finish up through the defense.
And that was a shot by Malik Fitz, got the roll.
And we had good contest on that, and they had cut in the lead to 1. And so this was, you know, we talked about adversity, being able to handle it throughout the game, and I thought we did a good job here of not, you know, falling into it and just toughing it up and bowing our backs. And really good finish by Martins over Guerrero right there.
And again, the great footwork. And in the second half, USF would tie it a couple of times, but then you start to pull away with Corey Henderson.
Nice pull-up Jay off that ball screen by Corey. And then a good ball ahead three right there by Corey. So Corey came in and made some nice, you know, some shots, really gave us when we were struggling a little bit there and got us going offensively.
And this is your example of a paint touch that results in an open three,
yes,
right?
Yes, and it doesn't, you know, we need those paint touches to create better spacing. And that doesn't mean we always shoot the ball in the paint, but when they defense rotate, we kick that ball out.
South Florida was hanging in there though, as you see with 12 minutes to go, the lead is 6 and Taplin makes it 9.
Yeah, and Tap had a little bit of a fall here, and you can see him moving a little gingerly with but he still finished strong, and that was a nice play by Junior driving against their zone.
And again, it'll be Junior E2 with really off a nice pass from Pat Bird.
Good high-low again here, and there we go. If the defense squeeze it, they kick it back out. Nice shot by Corey.
And you'd see there that South Florida had reduced the lead to 3, so a big shot for Corey Henderson at a terrific second half for you.
And Corey's got ready hands, ready feet. We've been on Corey about this at times. Sometimes he's not ready to shoot it, and he's such a terrific shooter. He's got to get himself ready on his setup. And good find here by Sterling with TK in the back of that zone, and a good finish by TK.
And the Hurricane still not out of the woods yet, but passes like that makes you feel awfully good, and you got a shot to win this thing.
Another high-low finish, but a great catch by TK right there.
And that gives Tulsa the 9-point lead. And down the stretch, you make your free throws, and you are on your way, as this is one of the largest leads of the ball game. In fact, it ends up being the final score because Pat Burt and finishes, or actually the steal there by Jaleel Wheeler. But you start with a Pat Burt steal, and you finish with a good defensive play by Jaleel Wheeler. Good overall performance, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Five players scored in double figures. You see us getting 43 points there in the second half. I think we had 45 the other night, so it was a really good performance by our team in terms of just playing really good team basketball.
And, you know, you can't overstate how important it is just to get a win, right? To get your confidence going a little.
Right,
huh?
And that's what it was. We just needed a win.
And Tulsa got it. And now can you build on the win? Tulsa at home against East Carolina. Highlights of the Sunday game coming up next.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show, and coaches, you get ready for East Carolina on Sunday. I guess the question is, how do you build on the success of Thursday?
Well, you know, we had some things we worked through in that game. We're really good in terms of had a little adversity. We fought through it, so we can build on that. And you know, because that's an area we struggle in, a 6-game losing streak. So it was good to see us fight through and build on it. Now we got another opportunity here against East Carolina.
So it's East Carolina, and it is Senior Day, and Senior Day is always emotional. And in this case, it is Pat Burt, who is going out with his dad and his mom, Michael and Sheila. That's always emotional, isn't it?
It is, and you just don't know how those are going to respond for that young man in terms of, you know, feeling the pressures of last game and the emotions that are involved, but I thought he did a really nice job.
Speaking of a nice job, that's Jaleel Wheeler going inside and getting the contact and getting the basket here in the early going.
Yeah, doing what he does best and attacking the rim, and there's a nice shot by our senior Pat Burt. Nice floater, you know, crossover, one hard dribble, off 2 feet, so he doesn't have a chance to charge, and that was a good play by Pat.
Yeah, and the big shot blocker, Washington, was right there, and a nice floater up over his hands. And the Golden Hurricane trailing here by 5, but Corey Henderson knocks that one down, and now he's down by 2.
Yeah, and you see Corey's ready hand, ready feet, to just be, I mean, being ready to shoot the ball and anticipate it, and that's, Corey's a good shooter when he does that.
And here's Sterling Taplin, who gets an opportunity. They go under the screen, and he knocks down the 3.
I think this stretch here, we made 3 straight 3s. They call a timeout. We had outscored them 9-0, 3, you know, Corey's 3, and then Sterling, and then now Gino with a guard behind 3. And it was good to see Gino get out there and get some minutes and play well yesterday.
And he played well on defense, too,
didn't he? He did. He had 2 rebounds and moved his feet, played physical, and that's important for Gino as his growth as a player.
And here's Corey Henderson, and he knocks that one down. Not afraid to go left and still take that shot, right?
No, he's got his rhythm. And great play by Sterling Taplin. That's, you know, Sterling's making these plays a lot during that stretch when he's playing at a high level. And just a terrific finish by him over to defense.
Yeah, you never know. Once you get that contact, you just get it up on the rim, and you have the chance for the old-fashioned 3.
Again, Corey, ready hand, ready feet. I think he had 4 threes here in the first half. You know, good finish by him.
And at the end of the half, you had a shot at the end, but a good job of running the clock down and taking the last shot, and there you have it, 29-27 at halftime. How are you feeling about it?
Good, because, you know, East Carolina's a good defensive team. I thought, you know, we had a stretch there where we got out of character a little bit offensively, but we got going here in the second half with our execution much better.
Nice inbounds play, and the layup by Junior Itu. He would have a terrific second half after being in foul trouble in the first.
Yeah, and that's a great play by Sterling Taplin. And we call this the Nash dribble, when you drive it in and you don't settle, because there's Washington, and you keep your dribble alive and find an open guy on the perimeter. And we've been encouraging Martins to shoot the ball because he's worked his tail off to being a good shooter. And there he hits 2 back-to-back 3s in a row. And, you know, we have to tell him to shoot it, but he's really developed to be a pretty good shooter.
And I think he's taking lessons from that guy, right?
Yeah, and when you got two big guys like he and Jr. that can step out and shoot, it makes your offense, your spacing, much better. Nice job by Sterling keeping the shot alive and finishing.
Offensive rebound results in a basket for TK Edogie.
Yeah, nice pass by Corey Henderson on that. And that's the way to stay after right here. And really good finish by TK on that loose ball.
And the Hurricane, again, not out of the woods, certainly a two-point game. And Junior Itu was outstanding in the second half.
He really was. And that was a quick two-ball screen where he sets that second screen. They were hedging out, so he's got a little space there, and a really good shot by him. He's shooting the ball at a high level right now.
Yeah, and ready to shoot, too. 20 points in the second half for Junior, and the miss shot. But how hard was that to jump, leap, have the ball hit the rim, and then he gets back up again and makes the play?
Yeah, he's a quick leaper, and there's TK scoring on a low post move over Washington, which is a really good shot, and jump hook. He's working on his skill set, and obviously it was a set play to get Martins the ball 2 feet in the paint, and he used his strength to get that shot up over the length of the East Carolina defense, and there's Junior again on a throwback three-pointer shot.
And then the Hurricane pulling away here, and Corey Henderson with a big one there for you.
Yeah, they go under that ball screen, and this is an ISO play here for Junior, obviously when he's got rhythm like that, shooting the ball is a good play for him. And we call this space play, and it's basically an ISO play. You saw us run against Temple, mm-hmm. where you get one-on-one with the guard, and nice finish by Sterling.
Yeah, and everybody else gets out of the way, right?
Yeah.
So that layup gives Tulsa the double-digit lead, and it ends up being a very satisfactory win for the Golden Hurricane. And here goes Pat Bird out of the game for the final time here at home.
Yeah, and I know Pat obviously wanted to play in terms of numbers a lot better, but I thought he played well. And, you know, Pat's hard on himself, and we've been working hard to get Pat to understand that it's not all about the numbers, man. But he had a really good career in terms of his 2 years and really helped us win a lot of ball games.
And an underrated defensive player here in his second season at TU.
Yeah, and he's been, you know, he's had to adjust to that, Bruce, in terms of being our best on-ball defender, and he's done a really nice job with that.
And you look at some of those numbers, Coach, and I think one of the ones that pops out at me is 55% three-point shooting. He shot 48% for the game, so the shooting is coming back now.
Yeah, and we were 65% in the second half, and that's, you know, when you want to try to lock in. And I thought our execution against a really good defensive team, we did did a really good job of shooting that ball and sharing it.
So the Golden Hurricane winning 2 at home to get to 8-8 in the league. We'll be back with more on the Frank Haith Show in a moment.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show and on the Don Thornton Cadillac feature segment. Everybody knows Michael Ruffin was a great rebounder, the all-time rebounder for TU, but On a night 20 years ago in Fort Worth, he had a spectacular double-double. On February 27, 1997, the Golden Hurricane traveled to Fort Worth to take on the TCU Horned Frogs. The Hurricane was in the midst of a run that would take them to the second round of the NCAA tournament, and little did we know that Michael Ruffin, who is TU's all-time leading rebounder, would match his great rebounding with a career high in scoring and arguably the most impressive double-double in TU history. And it almost didn't happen.
I remember being sick that day. Not even being sure if I was going to play, and if I did play, like how many minutes I was going to play.
Yes, Michael Ruffin would play, and what a game. You knew right from the start this would be something special for Ruffin. He was so good at keeping rebounds alive and then grasping onto the ball. He gets a defensive rebound, and then immediately at the other end on the offensive side, he's at the end of a lob from Shea Seals, and Ruffin and the Hurricane off to a great start.
As soon as the game started, I got on the court. And within the first couple of minutes, things just started going my way. It was an amazing feeling. The game just slowed down. It's like when the basketballs went on the rim, I was always in position. It was almost like they just came to me.
Ruffin was not only a great rebounder, but a great defender as well, as he walled off the driver and then plucked yet another rebound for the Hurricane.
Michael was a hardworking young man that really was very, very coachable. You know, off the court, he was kind of quiet and reserved, but on the court, very coachable, someone that competed very hard and had a heart of a lion.
What made this game special was Ruffin was not only getting rebounds, but he was getting scoring opportunities and was converting. And Ruffin's teammates were good at finding him that day. Eric Coley with a whip pass and Ruffin with a slam dunk.
The game seemed extremely easy. I was confident. I felt great. It didn't seem like I did much. You know, it just seemed like the ball just bounced my way. And in terms of scoring all the points, it just seemed like I was shooting layups and dunks.
We saw a lot of this in his career. Ruffin with a rebound slammer, and TCU that night had no answer for the Hurricane big man. Again, something we saw quite frequently with Ruffin, an offensive rebound and a putback, and TU was pulling away 65-41. That day, it was just like a broken record for Ruffin. Yet another offensive rebound, and Adrian Crawford eventually finds him for yet another finish at the rim.
It was a cool feeling to be out there and to be involved in that moment. It was an enjoyable experience, and I just enjoyed it. It was a fun game.
Certainly a fun game for everyone at this point. TU absolutely dominating the game, 86-52 with just under 12 minutes to play. And the question became, how many points and how many rebounds would Ruffin collect? And how long would he stay in the game? Well, the answer was only for another couple minutes. Ruffin came out of the game with about 8 minutes to play, and still Michael Ruffin ended up with 30 points and 24 rebounds, both career highs.
After the game, some of my teammates asked me, like, well, Michael, what did you do? How did you prepare? And I would always carry around a Michael Jordan Come Fly With Me video as a motivation. And I just kind of told them about that, and they teased me a little bit afterwards and just kind of said, well, you need to make sure you do that every game.
The greatest double-double in TU history. And the 128 points TU scored was the second highest ever for the Golden Hurricane. Well, 20 years ago, Coach, boy, what a performance. You don't find many 30-24s, do you?
No, Come Fly With Me video. I think we shared that with our guys. But no, he was terrific. I mean, just being quick off the floor and finishing around that basket.
And how many of those rebounds were 50-50? You know, taps to himself and that sort of thing.
Yeah, right? And it's about his quickness. And obviously, he had a high motor.
Absolutely. Michael Ruffin, terrific player for the Golden Hurricane. In a moment, we'll wrap things up on the Frank Haith Show.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with the name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds. The kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show, and as we take a look at the jumbled standings in the American, Coach, you can't figure it out just looking at it for a few seconds. You just got to go and try to win two games.
Right? Yeah, you just got to focus on what you do and all that other stuff and trying to figure out if they lose here or we win here. You just got to win. But there's not a lot of difference between fifth place and seventh place. I don't think we can finish our lower than seventh, but right. We could probably finish as high as tied for sixth or fifth. We just got to take care of business ourselves on the court.
And taking care of business means SMU, and obviously very good team.
Very good on both ends. You know, they're really, really talented offensively, defensively. They understand what their limitations are. They don't foul. They keep the ball in front of you. You know, we've got to play just a terrific game to go in their building and beat them. We did it last year, so I'm excited about the opportunity that our guys have on Thursday night.
And then the Hurricane will finish up the regular season on Sunday in New Orleans against Tulane. So we'll give you all the highlights next week of SMU and Tulane on the Frank Haith Show. So long for now.
The Frank Haith Show, brought to you by Don Thornton Cadillac, Pepsi, River Spirit, TTCU, The Credit Union, Bill Knight Ford, and St. Francis Health System. The Frank Haith Show has been a presentation of Golden Hurricane Sports Properties and a King Vision production.